Welcome back to Time of Death. This video is for informational purposes only and in no way meant to glorify or condone violence. In today's video, we'll be discussing the murder of Carlos Zarate. Zarate was shot several times Wednesday, April 22, 2009. The shooting took place in the 16100 block of Eucalyptus Avenue in Bellflower. Hector Arciga, Pedro Zuniga, and Francisco Parra were all arrested and charged with the murder. The following is the evidence at trial. According to the prosecution, the defendants had a scheme to rob drug dealers. After making an initial small purchase, they would set up a larger second purchase. During the second encounter, they would rob the drug dealer of the money and the drugs. Jesus Vasquez testified he was a close friend of the victim. About a week and a half before Zarate's murder, Vasquez was present when Zarate sold 20 pounds of marijuana to Parra and Zuniga. On April 22, 2009, Jesus Vasquez, Martha Gutierrez, Carlos Zarate, and Manuel Rojas went to an apartment in Bellflower to sell 140 pounds of marijuana to Parra and Zuniga. Parra was waiting outside the apartment. Zuniga and Arciga were waiting inside. The parties exchanged drugs and money. Arciga checked the product while Gutierrez started counting the money. Manuel Rojas testified that he realized it was a setup when Gutierrez was counting the stacks of money, and there were large bills on the top of the stacks and $1 bills underneath. At almost the same instant, Rojas heard someone say, "This is a stick-up." He saw the victim reach for his gun, but he didn't have enough time to pull it out before he was shot dead. After the victim fell to the ground, Gutierrez yelled out to run. Rojas panicked and ran toward the front door. Arciga then shot him in the left buttocks area, and Rojas fell to the ground. He closed his eyes and pretended to be dead. He heard people walking out and dragging the bag of drugs with them. As the last person left, he pistol-whipped them in the head. After the men left, Gutierrez had someone drive Rojas to a nearby hospital where he had surgery to repair his shattered left femur bone. Police officers interviewed Rojas at the hospital. He told them he had been shot in a drive-by shooting by unknown assailants. However, Rojas, who was working as an informant for the DEA, called his handler that day and informed them about what happened. A few days later, LA Sheriff Homicide Detective Stephen Black, after being informed that Rojas had information about the shooting, met with him, and Rojas described the actual events to the detective. On November 10, 2009, Parra was stopped for speeding. He was arrested for driving without a license, and the vehicle was impounded. During the search of the vehicle, two handguns were recovered from the trunk, including a 9mm Sig Sauer. Stephen Schultz, a coroner, testified that he performed an autopsy on Zarate's body. Zarate had suffered 9 gunshot wounds, including 3 that were fatal. Phil Terremoto, a criminalist, testified about firearm-related evidence recovered from the crime scene. From various tests, Terremoto concluded that 3 firearms were used during the shootout, including the 9mm Sig Sauer, the handgun recovered from Parra's vehicle. LA County Sheriff Deputy Mario Cortez, a latent print examiner, testified that he matched prints developed from evidence found at the crime scene with fingerprints from Parra and Zuniga. Luis Olmos, a criminalist, testified that Arciga and Zuniga were possible contributors of DNA analysis found on items at the crime scene. Following the trial, the jury found Arciga, Zuniga, and Parra guilty of first-degree murder, attempted murder, assault with a semi-automatic firearm, 4 counts of home invasion robbery, and first-degree burglary. The 3 men were sentenced to life in state prison without the possibility of parole. Carlos Zarate was 23 years old at the time of death.